Nuclear energy. Traditionally used sources of energy like wood, coal, and petroleum are not sufficient to meet the ever-increasing demand for energy. The shift from dependence on non-renewable sources of energy to dependence on renewable sources of energy is inevitable. In modern days, harnessing of nuclear energy has emerged as an alternate source of energy which has three things in it, where first one is charged particles emerged from neutral atoms. The radioactivity is a nuclear phenomenon. And the third one is during radioactivity, an atom gets transmutated into another along with the emission of charged species. The main advantage of nuclear reaction is the production of isotopes, which is radioactive and non-radioactive. When the radioactive isotope is generated during the nuclear reaction, it is termed as artificial radioactivity. If aluminium atoms are hit by alpha particles, we get phosphorus atoms, which will be radioactive. Nuclear fission and fusion are sustainable nuclear reactions. They can be used as a source of energy if carried out. A chain reaction is that process in which number of neutrons keep on multiplying after each fission rapidly in geometric progression till the whole of the fissionable material is disintegrated. In the chain reaction, if the number of neutrons produced is kept constant, then it is called controlled chain reaction. And if it is not controlled, the chain reaction enhances the number of neutrons and leads to explosion. In nuclear reactors, the chain reaction is controlled, whereas in nuclear bomb or atom bomb, it is uncontrolled. Naturally occurring uranium contains about 0.7% of 92 uranium-235 isotope, which is fissionable. To make it fissionable, 92 uranium-235 content of the ore is to be enriched by separating 92 uranium-235 and 92 uranium-238 isotopes. This process is known as enrichment of uranium. Energy is liberated during nuclear fission since the mass is transformed into energy. Practical consideration has been made to calculate 1 AMU to release energy, which is equivalent to 931 MeV. Approximately 1 electron volt means the energy gained by the electron when it is accelerated by applying a potential difference of 1 volt. Controlled nuclear reactions. Excess of neutrons are absorbed so that the number of neutrons per fission is regulated to around 1 neutron per fission, and this is controlled fission reaction. Analogy. LPG is highly combustible. If accidentally it catches fire, causes only destruction. The energy is not useful, but the same LPG can safely be used in the stoves by regulating the rate of combustion. Nuclear reactor. There are three important types of nuclear reactors. They are, first one is Brdo reactor, which is used to produce radioisotopes. Second one is power reactor, which is used to generate electricity. And third one is research reactor, which is used to carry out research programs related to atomic energy. Nuclear power reactors are very large reactors in which heat generated by nuclear fission is removed by water and the resulting steam is used to devise a large turbine connected to a generator. Nuclear fuel. The fissionable material is enriched uranium containing higher percentage of 92 uranium-235 isotope. There are Other fissionable materials like plutonium, which are used in nuclear reactors. The fuel is generally in the form of rods, which is placed in a regular array in a large container, and this constitutes the core of the reactor. Control rods. Control rods are made up of cadmium or boron carbide, which absorb neutrons efficiently. The reactor is said to be critical when the number of fissions per unit time remain constant, and this is achieved by increasing or decreasing the depth of the control rods in the core. Moderator. The fuel rods are surrounded by a moderator whose main purpose is to slow down neutrons emitted in the fission process. The slow-moving neutrons are more efficient in inducing fission. Heavy water and graphite are commonly used as moderators. The molecular formula of heavy water is H2O, but it is made from deuterium isotope of hydrogen 1H2. It is also represented as D2O. Its molecular mass number is approximately 20. Ordinary water contains a very small quantity of heavy water, which is approximately with a ratio of 1:6000. Reflector. Reflectors keep the neutrons confined to the core as much as possible. A moderator can also be used as reflector. Coolant. The large amount of energy released during the fission process appears as heat. This must be removed continuously by a coolant, which is also called as heat exchanger, because it transfers the heat of the reactor to water to produce steam. Liquid sodium metal, high boiling point, hydrocarbons, heavy water are some of the coolants. Generation of electricity. The pressure of the steam is used to rotate the turbines, which are attached to generators. Radiation shield. A thick layer of lead surrounded by very much thicker wall of concrete together act as effective shielding. Atomic energy in India. Bhabha Atomic Research Center is the major center for research and development work in atomic energy in India. The first atomic power station in India, called Tarapur Atomic Power Station, which started working in 1969 in Maharashtra. India's uranium supply comes mainly from Jadugoda mines in Bihar. India also imports enriched uranium from developed countries. Kota in Rajasthan, Kalpakkam in Tamil Nadu, Kaiga in Karnataka are the places where nuclear power reactors are functioning. Nuclear fusion. Under specific conditions, nuclei of light elements can combine to form a nucleus of high atomic number. The process by which two or more nuclei of lighter atoms combine to form a heavy nucleus with the liberation of large amount of energy is called nuclear fusion. For example, 1H2 plus 1H2 gives 2He4 plus energy. Nuclear weapons. Based on the principle of nuclear fission and nuclear fusion, we have two types of bombs, where first one is atom bomb, which is an example of fission bomb, and the second is hydrogen bomb, which is an example of fusion bomb. They are weapons of mass destruction, and their use and control has been a major aspect of international policy. Precautions such as lead jacket are necessary for the workers in the nuclear laboratories.